What's up, everyone? In this video, I'm going to be doing something a little different than my normal educational videos on the home buying process, and I'm actually going to be talking about what I think the top five areas in Northern Virginia are to get waterfront property, or at least be close to water. I have been fortunate enough to live by a body of water for most of my life, whether it be at least a creek, if not a river, and I can personally attest to the fact that in the hustle and bustle that goes on in Northern Virginia and DC, having that escape of some body of water can make a huge difference in your lifestyle. So in this video, I'm going to cover the top five areas that I've picked out, and for each of them, I'm going to go over three criteria. One, what the waterfront access actually is like. Two, the commutability. And three, the price of the neighborhood. Kicking it off at number five, we have Burke. Burke is actually an interesting one in the sense that there's actually two bodies of water next to it. There's Burke Lake, which is the obvious one, and actually the bigger body of water, and that one has really cool trails around it. There's a small par 3 course that's right next to it, and it even has a small little train that runs through it for the little kids who want to ride around while they're having a day with your family at the lake. There's also a second body of water called Lake Royal, which is a smaller one but still has access to water if you're looking for homes that aren't right on Burke Lake. So for that, you have a lot of options. In terms of commutability, I'm actually only going to give Burke 2 out of 5 stars because of all the options I'm going to talk about today, it has the least access for getting into the city as quickly as possible. There's no metro station that's really near it. It does have a VRE and it does have access to 395, but either option, more likely than not, you're gonna have to do a bit of driving to get into. In terms of pricing, it's gonna sit around the middle of the pack at $627,000 for the average home in that neighborhood. And like all the places I'm gonna talk about, there's obviously prices that will be above that and below that, but you're kind of sitting in the middle tier for that. Coming in at number four, we have Falls Church. Falls Church has Lake Barcroft as the area of water near it, and it actually is unique in the sense that it actually has private beaches where if you're a resident, you can pay for it and have access to these beaches where they actually have lifeguards, and even though it's a lake, you almost get that beach feel from it. In terms of commutability, I'm going to give it 3 out of 5 stars because although it is a little bit outside of the DC area, it has access to both East Falls Church and West Falls Church metro station depending on where you live. And in terms of price, it's actually a little bit higher than the Burke area and it's coming in at around $692,000 for the average price in the home. I gotta say, I'm a little bit biased for this next one, but coming in at number 3, I have Occoquan, Virginia. Occoquan is actually what I consider the biggest hidden gem of the options I'm going to talk about because although it's the furthest out, I think it has a lot to offer. It sits right on the Occoquan River and has marinas there as well as cute little restaurants that are right along the water, and it has this almost old-time feel of having a historic town while you're still just 21 miles outside of DC. In terms of commutability, I'm actually giving Occoquan 3 out of 5 stars, even though it's the furthest one away from DC out of the options I'm talking about. Occoquan is right off of 95, and you can jump on the highway and be in DC within 30 minutes if you hit it without hitting traffic, which is the big question when you're driving in Northern Virginia. In terms of pricing, Occoquan is going to be your best option on this list, with the average home price coming in at $579,000. But as someone who really studies this market locally, I can attest to the fact that for going just up the hill and not getting that waterfront property, but still being within walking distance, you can get homes for a much cheaper price point. Coming in at number 2, we have Old Town, Virginia. For anyone local to the area, you probably know about this spot because of its notoriety for the fact that it is one of the quaintest as well as most historical areas in Virginia. It's right in Alexandria and has access to the Potomac River. And in terms of accessibility, it actually has a ferry that runs through it. So you can get on that ferry and have a little boat ride into DC, as well as it goes across the river to where National Harbor is. It also has access to the Kingstown Metro Station, which is another way you can get into the city, making Old Town probably the strongest commuter option of the ones I'm going to talk about today. Because of that, as well as the fact that you have access to the parkway that can get you right into DC, I'm giving Old Town, Virginia 5 out of 5 for commutability. Because even though it's not right in DC, it's one of those areas where you can get into the city the quickest, as well as still not being in the city. When it comes to pricing, This is where you're gonna have to really break out your wallet though, because the average home price in Old Town, Virginia is $1,020,000 at the time of recording for this video. But as they say, you get what you pay for when you're looking for homes. And the number one waterfront property I'm gonna be talking about today actually isn't even in Northern Virginia, but it's just so good I had to throw it in, and that's Georgetown. Georgetown is technically in DC, although it sits right across from the Roslyn Bridge, so it is right on the outskirts of the Arlington, DC line, and it sits on the Potomac River as well. Georgetown sits in DC and is famous for its restaurants and shops, and actually has access to a little pathway where you can go running and places where you can go paddleboarding. So when you're talking about being in the city as well as having access to the Potomac River and then having some of the best eating and dining in the area, it's really tough to beat. Surprisingly, even though it's in DC, I'm only gonna give Georgetown 4 out of 5 stars in terms of commutability, because as someone who used to live in DC myself, you really largely get around in that city based on metro. And of all the areas in DC, I found that Georgetown has the worst metroing options. However, you're in there and you're either a short drive, walk, or Uber away from a spot in DC, so I can't be too harsh on it. But this one's definitely gonna be the priciest of all the options, and for good reason, but comes in at a whopping $1.39 million for the average home there, and there are definitely some in the area that go way higher than that. As someone that grew up in this area, as well as an agent, I get a chance to see a bunch of different neighborhoods, and these are the top 5 that I picked. But if you know of something different or disagree, feel free to leave a comment in if you know of a better space where you could get a sneaky waterfront property for a great steal. I hope you liked this video and found it helpful. Make sure to press the like button as well as subscribe to get notified when new videos are coming out talking about real estate as well as the home buying process. Thanks so much, and until next time.